Let us see what is chromosome. What is chromosome? So here, chromosome is a genetical material which is made up of DNA. Which is made up of DNA. Sir, here generally DNA, it forms into nucleosomes. DNA forms into nucleosomes. So this coiling of the nucleosomes will form chromatin material. Will form chromatin material. Okay na? Sir, what is chromosome? Chromosome is made up of DNA plus proteins. These proteins are called as histone proteins. So here, generally, the histone proteins, actually, five types of histone proteins are there. They are H1, H2A, H2B, H3, H4. So these are total five histone proteins. So except H1, these four proteins forms an actamer. These four proteins forms an actamer. So they may be H2A, H2B, H3, H4 and two sets. Four and four forms two sets double. So that is called, this is called as what? Actamer. So around this actamer, DNA is wrapped. So DNA is wrapped over the histone protein's actamer. Then it forms a nucleosome. Then it forms a nucleosome. So this kind of wrapping of or coiling of the DNA around the histone proteins will form you chromatin material. Chromatin material. Sir, chromatin materials are two types. Chromatin materials are two types. One is heterochromatin. One is heterochromatin. Second one is euchromatin. What is the second one? Euchromatin. Heterochromatin and euchromatin. Heterochromatin is the darkly stained chromatin material and highly coiled chromatin material, and it is not transcriptionally active. For example, if it is coiled like this, it is called as what? Super coiling. So when this is highly condensated chromosome, means these nucleosomes are coiled again and again and again. So then dark stained structure is formed, that is called as heterochromatin. Sir, heterochromatin is transcriptionally inactive. Transcriptionally inactive means what? It will not code for, any proteins. It will not code for any proteins. So this is heterochromatin. Okay. If you take euchromatin, so this is lightly coiled or lightly stained chromatin material. It is lightly stained chromatin material. It is not condensated. It is not darkly condensated or darkly stained. So this is lightly coiled. And euchromatin is transcriptionally active. Euchromatin is transcriptionally active. Okay, that means it will code for the protein. It will code for the protein. It will not code for any protein. Transcriptionally inactive, transcriptionally active. Okay, now next. What is genome? What is genome? Sir, what is a chromosome first? Chromosome is made up of what? DNA plus histone proteins. DNA plus histone proteins. DNA wraps around the histone proteins and it will form nucleosome. These repeated coiling of the nucleosomes will form chromatin material. And this chromatin material is how many types? Two types. So darkly condensated chromatin material is heterochromatin. It is transcriptionally inactive. It do not codes for any proteins. Euchromatin is lightly stained molecule. And this lightly stained chromatin is transcriptionally active. Okay, now. So next, genome. What is genome? So genome is nothing but the total set of DNA molecules which present in the individual is called as genome. Sir, genome is nothing but the total set of genes which present in the individual cell is called as genome. For example, we have 30,000 genes. We have 30,000 genes. That is called as our genome. Genome can be said as the total number of genes present in an individual's DNA or chromatin material or in the cell. That is called as genome. Otherwise, DNA is nothing but the total set of DNA molecules which present in the individual cell is called as genome. If you take the genome of the individual, only 2% of the genome is coding for proteins. How much? 2% of the genome is coding for proteins. The remaining DNA is not coding for any proteins. So the major function of the genome or genes is nothing but expression of characters. Okay, now. So genes must be expressed their characters in the form of different things in an individual. So when a fragment of the DNA is not coding for any proteins, then it is said to be junk DNA. What is that? Junk DNA. So what is the junk DNA? What is the definition? The part of the DNA which do not code for, any proteins is called as junk DNA. Okay, now let us see Human Genome Project. So here, Human Genome Project, it was a mega project. It was started in October 1990, sir. So when this Human Genome Project was started, in October 1990, it was started. And here it was a 13 years of project. Actually, they thought that this Human Genome Project will take 15 years of time. But as we have well-developed tools for the study of genome, well-developed equipments for the study of genome, analysis, recording of the data, we have developed tools. So here, improved tools helped for the reduction of time for the completion of Human Genome Project. So Human Genome Project was completed in 2003. So it took 13 years of time for its completion. Okay, sir, here generally what organizations have started, so this project, actually United States of America, US Department of Energy, United States of America, Department of Energy, as well as this is also American Institute, National Institute of Health, as well as generally Wellcome Trust. What is this? Wellcome Trust, which belongs to the UK, means England. So Britain. So US Department of Energy, National Institute of Health, with the support of Wellcome Trust from the England, they have started Human Genome Project. Sir, here, generally there are some other countries which took part in this Human Genome Project. If you take Japan, okay, Germany, France, China. So these are the some other countries. Helped for Human Genome Project. Okay, so it was actually started by United States of America and also United Kingdom, means London. So these United States of America and London started this Human Genome Project, but some other countries also supported, helped for this project. Japan, Germany, and France, China. So these four countries also have assisted their help for the Human Genome Project. So then Human Genome Project was completed in 2003. Okay, next, what are the goals of Human Genome Project? So what are the goals of Human Genome Project? Sir, here Human Genome Project was started to identify the total number of genes which present in the human genome and their characters. For example, first point, to identify the total number of genes, 30,000 genes in the human beings. Okay, now 30,000 genes were must be identified in the goals. So goals of HGP, Human Genome Project. So sequencing of 30,000 genes and identification of 3 billion nucleotide sequences. 3 billion nucleotide sequences are nitrogen base pairs. Okay, now next thing is improving tools for the study. Next, and this HGP is used for some issues. It is used for ethical, social, legal issues. So ethical issues, legal issues, and social issues. So here, to solve the ethical, social, legal issues, so this Human Genome Project is necessary. So these are the goals of HGP. And improving tools for the gene therapy means identification of the damaged genes, how that disorders can be treated. These are all the goals of HGP. First, their goal is we have to identify the total number of genes present in an individual's DNA. Okay, now, so means generally human being have 30,000 genes. What are those 30,000 genes? And genes are responsible for what characters? That is the first goal. Second goal, we have 3 billion nucleotide sequences. In a DNA, we have 3 billion nitrogen base pair sequences. So here, we have to sequence them. Next one is improving tools for the study. Means when we know the genome, so what type of tools are required for the development of that may be treatment, that may be any kind of changes in the genome. So improving tools. Next one, some ethical problems, the social problems, legal problems can be solved by the Human Genome Project. These are the four important goals of Human Genome Project. Okay, next. So here, after the successive identification of Human Genome Project or completion of Human Genome Project, they have also sequenced not only human being genome, they also sequenced bacteria, okay, yeast, Cyanobacteria elegans, next rice, next Drosophila, next Arabidopsis. So one more is bacteria total genome was sequenced, yeast genome sequenced, Cyanobacteria elegans, this is a nematode, sir. So nematode DNA also sequenced, rice DNA sequenced, Drosophila, which is commonly called as fruit fly, its genome also sequenced, Arabidopsis thaliana, this is evening primrose plant, so Arabidopsis thaliana DNA also sequenced. Okay, na? Next. DNA sequencing. So DNA sequencing mechanism. Sir, here generally DNA sequencing mechanism, if you see, so if you take the DNA sequencing mechanism, there are two types of mechanisms are there in the DNA sequencing system. So one is only the expressed genes are isolated. Only what are the genes isolated? Only expressed genes. Isn't it? Expressed genes means the genes which are responsible for the proteins, the genes which are responsible for the characters are isolated.